One of the questions I keep getting often is, what is the right sequence to do yoga? Should I start with asana? Should I start with Surya Namaskara? Or can I do pranayama as soon as I wake up? In this video, I'll answer these questions. Most of us are aware of 8 limbs of yoga propounded by Patanjali, and they go in a proper sequence. Since yoga is a lifestyle, you just can't be following a sequence only when you're on the mat. You have to inculcate it in your everyday life. But when you're on the mat, what I'll be telling next is the best way to start your sadhana or practice. Firstly, you'll have to spend some time in observing or noticing your breath and be mindful of the changes. Once you're done with this, it's important that you start breathing with awareness. A proper breathing will expand your stomach and chest when you inhale and returns to normalcy when you exhale. This stabilizes the breath and lets you be relaxed. After this, it's important that you chant Omkara for a few times to create vibrations within the system and stabilize your mind as well. As I've said in one of my videos, chanting doesn't have any religious attributes attached to it. A prayer should be followed for the well-being of oneself and everything around.
Om Sahanavavato Sahanau Bhunakto Sahaviryam Karavavahe Tejasvinavadhitamastuma Vidvishavahe Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Saying a prayer has deep psychological effects. Unlike other physical activities, yoga puts breathing before anything else. So your first practice must be a slow breathing practice where you try to synchronize the breathing with a hand movement or body movement. Here, great emphasis is laid on slow, deeper breath and movement which matches it. This sends a message to the brain to match or slow down the rhythm of the heart and other pulsations within the body. Most people who feel morning stiffness will be able to feel a greater difference in their practice if they adopt this method. There are many such synchronous breathing practices one can perform. Because I'm just talking about the right sequence, I won't be going in detail about the individual practices you are seeing. After these breathing practices, you must be warming up the body with any exercise which raises the cardiac rate like a simple spot jog or squats. This increases the blood flow to the different muscles of the body, activating and preparing for the next sequence. Doing the next sequences without a good warm-up might not be effective and can lead to injury in some cases. The next best practice for a good sequence is Surya Namaskara. While some consider this itself as a warm-up, I recommend that you do everything you saw before in the sequence for Surya Namaskara to be most effective. I have made a video on doing Surya Namaskara the right way. You can check that out for proper execution. Surya Namaskara helps in stimulating deeper muscles, sinews and joints, which in turn will benefit the asana practice and also regulates the breath and improves the lung capacity needed for deeper pranayamas. The series of asana needs to be proper and I recommend a beginner to be extra cautious during the transitions. The next practice in the sequence is asana, and here what you practice can be selective according to the individual practitioner, but generally starting off with simpler asanas and the asanas that help you in performing advanced postures is recommended. This can include balancing postures, standing postures, sitting postures, prone postures, supine postures and inversions. So what all should you practice within these positions? Again, it depends on the individual's capacity, but what's general and effective is to include a forward bend. And this is the case both in sitting and standing. There are a wide variety of asanas you can choose and you can change what you perform every day since it targets the same parts of the body. A back bend, which again can be performed in standing, sitting, prone or supine. A side bend, which gives the lateral movement to the spine either in standing or sitting. A twist, which helps in improving the flexibility of the spine and improving digestion. An inversion, which helps in channelizing the blood flow back to the heart and elevating the mood. Once you perform this, you can attempt advanced asanas with more stability and success, as your body, mind and breath will be more stable and ready to accept challenging positions. To reiterate what I said, I'll not go in detail of the postures because here I'm just showing the best sequence that one can follow. After the practice of asanas, your body would be ready for pranayama, but before that you must try to rest in shavasana and compare the present feeling with that of how you felt before you started the practice. Once you are rested, you can do your pranayama practice, and again, this depends on the level you are at, but if you are a beginner, I highly recommend doing pranayama under the supervision of a teacher. After this, you can lie down back in shavasana for deeper relaxation of the physical and mental state, which vitalizes the entire system. The sequence that I have mentioned in this video works best for a healthy, normal person, and in case of any problems or diseases, there will be a particular sequence and set of practices one has to perform. And for this, they have to consult a yoga therapist before and follow their guidance. Rest of you can adopt this sequence for the best results. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. Share your thoughts in the comment section, hit that thumbs up, kindly subscribe and hit that bell icon. Shubhamastu.